play neutral. It comes pretty naturally.
And you know what? K9's one of those players, too, that really, really picks up a character who's good, too, and he'll just practice lab, and master that character. So, honestly, I'm looking forward to seeing his Lucina, too. Haven't seen it out in a while.
He's Mr. Neutral, too. He's never been, like, the flashiest player, you know, in Smash 4 when him and Void played Sheik. They would go Game 5, last hit for Mega Sheik Mondays pretty much every week. Mm-hmm. But Void would be the combo crazy one, and K9 would just be neutral, just beat you in neutral over and over and over. So Lucina, I think, plays into K9's strengths a lot here. And Bow is just a wild card, dude.
He really is. That's the best way to describe him.
Some of the best sets I've ever commentated were FOW versus somebody. So this is really exciting for me.
Doesn't matter who he brings the hype, always. but yeah, actually.
K9 with a nice start. Let's go.
Just about to say.
Might have a little bit of bias here. A little bit of SoCal bias. I'm sorry.
A little bit, but actually consistently just being really patient, waiting. Waiting. He's kind of going in, but he's not going too much, and he's kind of hesitating, waiting for FOW to do an unsafe. Well, actually, all of Ness's aerials are pretty safe and good, but he's waiting for him to kind of make the first mistake option here, and he's capitalizing off of that. The yo-yo, that is so good.
You want to talk about it?
I don't.
Whoa, that was a good edge guard.
That was.
He doesn't have a jump. He can counter here.
Yes.
It's the counter.
Wow.
K9 with a really solid start. And this is what I'm talking about. Almost that entire stock was K9 standing still on the left side of the stage and waiting for FOW to run up and do something, and then he's punishing it.
Yeah,
that's what he's
insane.
Doing again.
Yeah, he's just waiting for that was a nice air dodge up. For him to just come in, land unsafely. I mean, obviously Ness's aerials are godlike, but it's just he's playing really, really patient, and he's ready to take and beat FOW.
Yeah. No, he's hungry.
Like, he's hungry.
K9's wanted this since Brawl. That's a long time.
Yeah.
You know, when Brawl came out, I was in middle school. That's nuts.
Yeah, that's crazy.
So that's a long time to want to beat somebody in something.
All right, good grab. Gonna get that forward throw. Maybe put it in that situation again.
Ooh,
no,
nice
yeah.
Nair, though. Really turned the situation around. It looked like FOW was in disadvantage there, but gets the Nair. FOW, like I said, the other thing that plays into K9's advantage right now is that Ness actually could have a pretty tough time comboing Lucina. Lucina's pretty floaty, and she has that pretty quick fare to get out of combos if you're not like really quick with it. Ness is floaty as well, so he has a hard time like just running up and capitalizing on hits like that. So this is a really smart pick from K9, and it's working out really well in game one at least. As long as he doesn't throw his lead, finds a couple more counters off stage.
Why do I feel like he's been practicing this like every day of his life? He's playing.
He's been
really
training in the mountains, just waiting for K9 versus FOW.
Oh, yes.
At the Wednesday night fights where it really matters if you beat FOW or not.
Wow, yeah, that up tilt actually had a lot of the knockback, sent him way up. Okay, yeah, looking. Yeah, when Ness gets a grab, that is a scary time.
Nice. That still doesn't kill. Wow. Okay, FOW is in a really good spot right now. But I mean, obviously still a bad spot, but if he can get a punish right here,
what?
He can really turn this game around.
Okay. Oh, wow, that was clean.
Oh, my God.
That was good. I think he was at like 70%,
yeah,
and then that ended up taking him out.
You know, I thought he was just going to back throw. That's what I was talking about. But FOW had other plans. Just gets down smash into PK Thunder into up air.
He never just takes the stock like how you expect, though.
That's true. FOW has to play it cool somehow.
Oh, yeah.
He has to find a way to be a crowd favorite.
Okay,
oh, no,
yeah, going for the uppy out of shield.
Oh, okay, fishy for it.
But FOW did not punish him for that, so.
Yeah.
Luckily, yeah, K9 was.
Oh my god, this was looking so good for K9, and it only took one moment for FOW to get momentum, and then FOW with momentum is a terrifying thing.
And living at 216%.
Yeah.
This is definitely where he should not be. K9 needs to get the stock.
This man just PK flashed for no reason down there. That was so unnecessary.
I know. I think
cool,
he just did it to throw him off.
It was very necessary.
It's like a stall.
It stopped the timing of the upbeat. I'm just joking, everyone. Don't yell at me. What? Why? Oh, my God.
Oh, that Nair hit from below. Excuse me?
Forward throw. This is really rough for K9. I don't know if he has a way to avoid the PK Thunder.
Brought him. Okay, nice. That was a nice back air there. To cancel out that PK Thunder. Oh, back throw's going to take it from
so
the
clean.
Center.
FOW threatened with the back air three times. It forced K9 to get scared and kind of shield, and then FOW just runs up and gets the free grab.
No, yeah, that was a big turnaround there. K9 was consistently, he had the lead for a really long time, and FOW just brought that back within like a snap of my finger.
K9 does not
what even happened?
Angry. He looks sad. and K9 plays better when he's angry.
I know. K9 actually, I always tell him every time, he levels up. When he like channels this inner rage inside of him, it just kind of like heats him up. He gets his blood pumping, and he just... He goes ham.
He really does.
Super Saiyan.
I don't know if I agree with this pick. I think that the Lucina was working wonders for K9, and he literally misstepped once, and it was just a huge momentum swing for FOW, and that's why that game went downhill. It was not because of K9's decision-making with the Lucina. It was because FOW got such a sick conversion in order to take the lead that he just ran away with it. So, I mean, again, K9 starting with a lead, but this, I mean, you could see it in K9 when he was debating the character switch. He knows that this is a risky choice, so we'll see how it works out.
Yeah, he definitely took a long time before making this decision, but at the same time, he probably just feels a little more comfortable with Wolf.
Yeah.
Maybe even in this matchup, too. Maybe he was just feeling like, you know what, like, I don't want to go out that way. At least I want to try somebody else.
Sure.
But yeah, you're going to get him off stage with that forward throw, trying to go for something there. But yeah, Ness is a little hard to edgeguard sometimes.
He's got a third jump.
That's it.
How is that okay?
I don't know. That shield pokes you all the every time. It's really good.
Shouldn't be too difficult for K9 to seal out this stock. Back throw's not going to do it without any rage. But he should be able to find a back air or a nair even at the ledge.
Down tilt?
Yeah, down tilt works too. Oh, no. Got antsy. Tried to punish the air dodge. Wasn't the strong nair, so it doesn't kill. Down tilt again. Oh, no.
Going for something there.
Chill, K9.
Yeah, a little scary, but you know he wants it so bad.
Yeah.
And that's what I was saying.
There we go.
Yeah, Wolf's a little... It's scary when he goes off stage to try to go for some proper edge guard because he just does not have a good jump recovery.
No.
This K9.
This is rough.
No, the yo-yo.
That was so godlike.
What?
Oh, played that perfectly.
What did you do?
There was nowhere for K9 to do. Just put
the controller
down.
There was no opening. No,
it
yeah.
would have been better to just die.
That's
go through that.
That's where you need to capitalize off of Wolf players off stage. And FOW did exactly that and took all of his options into play.
That was nuts.
Wow.
Oh, wait, you got the air dodge here?
Doesn't matter.
I get a down air? No, he doesn't get that down air. He really needed that edge guard. I think that could have been a comeback, but I don't know if K9 is going to get to fulfill his destiny today and beat FOW.
Yeah,
I have to wait. For another time.
He probably should have stuck with Lucina there.
I still think the Lucina was... Like, Lucina never would have been in that situation that just got him killed, right? That edge guard situation.
Mm-hmm.
Lucina just would have dipped low, recovered, and none of that would have happened.
All right, we actually can't see K9 do this, so he could bring this
back. Did I speak too soon? Is this the anime twist?
Wow. No. If anyone could do this, it could be K9 for sure. Definitely has that comeback factor.
He's leaned forward.
Ooh.
Oh, he's looking good.
Powering up.
We're
seeing level up K9 right now.
I want to see a game three so bad.
No.
I don't really care who wins, but I want to see a game three.
Oh, he tried reflecting the PK Thunder there. Lands safely. No. Back air's going to do it.
FOW takes it over K9, but amazing effort there at the end from K9. He was one or two good conversions away from taking that set, taking that game.
Yeah, if he just leveled up a little earlier, he might have been able to do it. But
still heartbreaking to see that K9 is not going to be able to defeat his ultimate demon yet, but I have faith that he'll come back and do it eventually. Maybe they'll get to play again this tournament in, like, loser semi. That'd be the ultimate timeline.
That'd be fun. I'm glad we got to commentate, though. I just wish it really went to a game three. That would have been super... Super hyped to see that be fulfilled. But yeah, nevertheless, good set and good games to FOW and K9. FOW's, just one of those players, man. Super rough. Are we circulating out?
So they said we were going to switch every hour, and our pool starts in 1 minute. So we definitely have to go. Hobby, our pool starts in a minute. So can we switch? But it has been a pleasure, guys. Thank you so much.
Yeah, it was a pleasure commentating with you, Pluto, for a little bit. I'm glad. That was a quick, fast hour, too. That was actually
four quick ones.
I know. That was awesome.
Those were fun sets. Got to commentate some high-level players.
Looks like we're probably going to get Edmund on the mic. Thank you guys so much again for tuning in, watching again. I'm Arisdale. This is Pluto. And, we might be back on tonight, but we got a lot of
There's a lot of people who want to cast.
Yeah.
So maybe. I'll try to get back on. But see you guys later. Thanks for watching.
Take care, guys.